Howdy, y'all. My name is Thor Harris. I want to tell you about my love for Sled Island Fest. I love the people who put it on. I love Mode and all y'all's posse up there in Calgary. I played it that fucking year that it flooded. Played it with Swans. We played, and that night it started raining, and we were sort of watching it, and they were saying on the news, this is gonna be big. We flew to Europe the next morning, just barely got out before the fucking apocalypse. And then when we landed in Europe, we're looking at TVs, and y'all are in the news. Whole town was underwater. And then, a couple years later, I came back and did a talk on depression. Because I know stuff about depression. And that was really cool. His doctor chimed in, and he had dealt with depression. He told everyone to get a dog. He was awesome. And I met my friend Steph. She's a puppeteer. Then I think a couple years after that, Thor and friends played, and we went to that rad synthesizer museum that y'all have. Love Sled Island. Also once, in that hotel, what's it called, the Fairmont, I rode in an elevator with Daniel Lanois, but I thought he was Billy Bob Thornton, but I wasn't sure, so I didn't say anything. Ugh, such a buffoon. Do y'all miss my little finger as much as I do? I saw it the other day, because the doctor had to rewrap it. It looked weird, like it wasn't even part of my body anymore. You know what they say about Calgary? No, wait. You know what they say about Texas? That it's the Calgary of the South. We got cows and oil and conservative assholes, just like y'all do. I love my sister. When she dies, she's going to live with Jesus forever. Sounds like a long time to me. I mean, if I stick around here for 80 or 100 years, I'll be done, you know? I don't want to have to go somewhere, continue on. I need some rest. I hope she's wrong. Listen up, y'all. I got some good advice, because I'm old and I've been paying attention for a long time. Never, ever pretend to be smarter than you actually are. Everyone hates an asshole trying to pretend to be smart. However, pretending to be stupider than you are is fine. It's actually pretty funny. I'm Dick Sandwich, and I'm wearing leather pants. Today we're going to talk to a few of Austin's punk rock dinosaurs. Well, back in the late 70s, early 80s, even in the 90s, we were forming some pretty cool bands down there. Scratch Acid, Butthole Surfers, The Dicks, Big Boys. And then some of these fucking tech dorks start coming to South by Southwest and getting laid for the first time. And then they're like, hey, I hear Austin, Texas is pretty cool. Maybe we should move the office down there. Next goddamn thing you know, rent's a fucking $2,000 a month and a house cost a half a million. God fucking damn it. It smells weird in here. Would you agree? Or would you agree to disagree?
Would you agree to disagree on future topics when they arise? Thank you. Life hacks.
Hi. If you're bored and life isn't what you had hoped, you could take a clothespin like this, push down here, and it jumps like a frog. Life hacks.
Y'all know that song Guns of Navarone by the Scottalites? God, that jam is magic. It's been blowing my fucking mind for decades. Still, every time it comes on, life hacks. This is Chaco Canyon, New Mexico. People built these structures about 1,000 years ago. You should come here if you get the chance. It's a strange place. Wonder what will come of everything we're building now. Similar fate, I'm sure. Dear Drugs, congratulations on winning the war on drugs. Dear Terror, congratulations on winning the war on terror. Americans are more terrified than ever. Dear Poverty, congratulations on winning the war on poverty. The rich got tax cuts. The poor got poisonous water.
Hello, Sled Island. It's me, Dick Sandwich. And I'm wearing leather pants. I'm reporting to you from the year 2085. Behind me is the skyline of what used to be Houston, Texas. The last human died off a few years ago. It's been rather quiet. All these species are starting to regenerate and evolve into new species. So that's the end of the Anthropocene. What else can we say? It was a nice run, humans. Back to you, Nigel.
Hi y'all. Well, as you've no doubt noticed, the apocalypse is underway. For God's sake, don't blame yourself. This was, you know, in the works for thousands of years. Just take care of each other and be nice to animals and don't have kids. Take care of them if you already did. All right, y'all. Life hacks.